Since 1982, Ridley Scott's Blade Runner got hundreds of reviews, ranging from positive to negative, from mainstream to obscure. If a human read through all those reviews, he or she could tell that they refer to the same movie rather easily. But how could a machine face up to the same situation? Change the wording in the slightest manner, and even the most famous computational tool fails. That is because organic brains understand the meaning of words. They are aware of the relationships between words, whereas computers are limited to matching patterns of letters. My research is about bridging the gap between organic and computational intelligence. To do that, I'm introducing formal ontologies to computing systems. Much like normal dictionaries that explain complex words by using other, simpler words, ontologies define relationships between terms in a way that machines can understand by using the language of formal logic. Now, that is a challenge in most domains, but imagine what it would bring if we could make that sort of understanding possible with systems that are already powerful, systems that can self-manage. Your phone may be such a system in the nearby future. If it were able to download software updates and predict security threats without disturbing your calls or web browsing, then it would be a self-managing system. The challenge with that approach is that ontologies do not miraculously fit within computational systems on their own. They need to be eased into it, and certain analysis needs to be carried out to make sure that these two components work well together. So in my research, I'm developing a semantic framework to describe formally the requirements that these two components need to fulfill in order to fit in the same framework. My research has a practical component as well, as I'm currently trying to build a software application that automatically changes the way that text and images are displayed in a document in relation to a reader's level of focus as picked up by a camera. My results, the ones that I've published so far, look promising, and I am looking forward to exploring how these two seemingly different, yet inherently and fundamentally compatible technologies will mix in the future. I'm Alina Patelli. Thank you.